Ciao, I'm Chiara from Perfile Segno and welcome back to my channel. In this video, I will show you how to crochet this beautiful pillow cover using Alpine Stitch, a very easy texture stitch. For this project, I use a Caramella yarn from Mondial. You can find more information in the info box below and 6.0mm hook. And a pillow form, this is 40 by 40 cm. Okay, this pattern requires an even number of chains, so we do chain 42. Now we're done chain 42, and so now we'll start row 1. Now we do 1 single crochet in the second chain, then single crochet across. Okay, I've just finished my first row and now to begin the second row, chain 3 and turn. Now skip the first and in the second stitch we do 1 double crochet and do this all the way along the row. Now we're finished the second row and we simply turn our work around and begin chain 1. We do 1 single crochet in each stitch of the previous row. Okay, now we are ready to start with an Alpine Stitch pattern that consists of a repeat the next 4 rows. So, chain 3 and turn your work. And now we'll be doing the first front post double crochet in the double crochet below it, which is 2 rows below. So, yarn over. Then insert your hook from front to back behind the post. Then yarn over and pull a long loop. Yarn over again and pull through the 2 loops. Yarn over again and pull through the last 2 loops. And this is the first front post double crochet. Now 1 double crochet in the next stitch. And now we'll do another front post double crochet in the 2 rows below. Insert your hook in the double crochet. And this is the second front post. And do 1 double crochet in the next stitch. And now continue to alternate this sequence. Work the last front double crochet and do the 1 double crochet in the last stitch. And now we will do a single crochet row. So chain one and turn, and we do one single crochet in each stitch. Okay, for row 6, chain 3 and turn. And now we do one double crochet, one simple double crochet in the next stitch, here over the front post. And we will do the first front post for this row here in the double crochet below. Okay, so one double crochet in the next stitch and one front post double crochet in the double crochet down below, two rows below. And now we do one double crochet in the next and one front double crochet again, and continue to alternate this sequence. And now we do one double crochet in the last two stitches. So now row 6 is complete. For row 7, we will do one single crochet. So chain 1 and one single crochet in each stitch. Now we are just going to keep repeating row 4 and then 5 and row 6 then 7 until you have a panel about 33 centimeters or 13 inches. Turn your work, chain 3, then one front post double crochet here and one double crochet in the next stitch. Okay, now I have finished my first panel. It's about 33 centimeters or 30 inch. And this is the second one. So now we are going to sew the two panels together using crab stitch. But before proceeding, grab your yarn needle and we are going to weave the tails inside the panel. Thank you. Okay, now we are going to start sewing these panels together, and we are going to do that by taking the wrong side and we are going to place them together just like this. We attach some clip all around to keep the panels together. So now insert your hook in one corner and do a crab stitch all the way around. Crab stitch or reverse single crochet is the most popular crochet border stitch. What we have to do now is to work a single crochet in opposite direction that you have been working before. So chain one, then one single crochet in the opposite direction and continues for three sides of the pillow. Now we are ready to put the pillow form in the pillow cover, and now we are going to sew and close the pillow using crab stitch as we did before. So, take your hook and close this last side. And now we cut the yarn and pull the yarn to make a knot. And now we are going to weave the tails inside the pillow. Okay, Caramella Pillow is now complete. As you can see, the Alpine Stitch is a very nice and easy textured stitch. I hope you enjoyed this video tutorial. Let me know in the comments down below. So thank you for watching and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao and tanto love!